Hi, this is Brian Lazar from the Colorado Avalanche Information Center. Thanks for tuning in to your weekly update. If we take a look at current conditions right now, you'll see on our homepage map that we've got some areas of moderate danger through the middle portion of the state. This is a welcome change from the green across the entire map that we saw last week, which was unfortunately driven by little to no snowfall for much of November. We did get about 3 to 6 inches of snowfall that took place on Monday, and this led to a slight increase in avalanche danger across the middle portions of the state. This is just an early indication of what's to come. So if we look at some images just from what happened here is we had a pre-existing very weak snow surface. This is an example of a surface hoar crystal, which is widespread throughout the state. These are very fragile, weak layers, and this makes up a good chunk of our snowpack in most locations. Surface hoar and sugary faceted snow from top to bottom. This is not a foundation that can support much additional loading, and just the 3 to 6 inches of snow we got with a teeny bit of wind led to some early indications of what we can expect as we move towards the weekend. We saw drifting snow onto leeward slopes, and this caused cracking in the snowpack. And these are some skier-triggered small avalanches that took place in the storm snow from just the last day or two. And you can see the cracking is already evident. Here's a skier-triggered slab up near Crested Butte. And then you can see just 6 inches of snow on this very fragile snow surface caused cracking in the snowpack without the additional weight of a person. So this is just an early indication of what's to come. What we've got on our doorstep is a fairly potent storm. So what I'm going to show here is a numerical weather model. This is the CAIC's high resolution 2 kilometer WRF model, but many of the models are in very good agreement that we're in for some very heavy snowfall with high precipitation rates starting tonight and moving into Thursday and Friday morning. And so this is going to show you total snow accumulation. And starting today, and you can see that the snow just continues to stack up. By the time we get into Friday morning, we're looking at places that are going to see 2 feet. Those are indicated by kind of the pink and purple areas. And some of these specific locations throughout the state could see as much as 3 feet, which are indicated by those white areas. Those target areas are really confined to the Park Range north of Steamboat and some portions of the West Elk Mountains. And so what we are anticipating is a dramatic increase in avalanche danger as we move into tomorrow and peak instability occurring Thursday night. So we've already issued for these places that we expect lots of snow, avalanche watch in place. This is on Wednesday afternoon. We anticipate that we could actually reach very dangerous avalanche conditions, high avalanche danger, which is level 4 out of 5. In these places with the watch by late tomorrow, and peak instability is Thursday night into early Friday morning. So the watch has already been issued, which means we could see warning criteria as early as Thursday afternoon. This is for the Steamboat area, the Aspen zone, the Gunnison zone, the North San Juan, and the South San Juan. So you can see this is a pretty dramatic change. We are moving from low danger in some places all the way to the upper end of the avalanche danger scale. So people really need to be aware of dramatically and quickly rising avalanche danger in very dynamic conditions. It's going to be imperative you stay tuned into the avalanche forecast at colorado.gov/avalanche, or check current avalanche conditions on your smartphone app, the CAIC smartphone app. And be prepared for very dangerous conditions as we head into Friday and the weekend. And we might reach the point where we are not recommending travel in backcountry avalanche terrain in places that receive upwards of 2 feet or more snow. So thanks for tuning in. Please stay safe. We're all excited to see a change in the weather pattern. It's great to see snow return. It's great to see winter return. Please keep in mind this is going to coincide with a very dramatic uptick in avalanche danger. So everyone stay safe, check your forecast, and stick to low-angle terrain until all this new snow settles out.